Good evening. My name is Jennifer Burden, and I'm the Dean of Instruction. Welcome to our sixth annual Distinguished Level of Achievement with Collegiate Honors Southwest Early College High School Scholars Banquet. You are surrounded by friends, family, PSGA administration, teachers, and staff, and we honor your achievements. Move forward with pride through tonight's events and other ceremonies that are of great significance for two reasons. One, because they celebrate the end of your successful public school career, and two, because we look to the next chapter when you will become our leaders and take the world in your hands. You have shown through grit and determination that you are ready and prepared, and we wait in anticipation for what you will do and how you will change the world. To our parents, we also honor you tonight. It has taken countless hours and years of self-sacrifice to prepare your children for this moment. Thank you. Your children will go on to make us all so very deeply proud. At this time, would everyone please stand for the presentation of colors and presentation of colors. The presentation of colors will be performed by PSGA Southwest Early College School JROTC Javelina Battalion Color Guard. The Color Guard is under the direction of Senior Armor Instructor Major James Kellum and Sergeant First Class Jose Leal. Right guard is Cadet Corporal Gaspar Castro. Carrying the U.S. flag, Cadet Lieutenant Colonel Lexi Kintai. Carrying the Texas flag, Cadet Captain Isaac Ramirez. Left guard, Cadet Sergeant First Class Luis Cantu. May I call Nayeli Salazar up to the podium, please, our Student Council President, to lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Honor the Texas flag. I pledge allegiance to the Texas, one state, under God, one and indivisible.
Thank you, Nayeli. Now may I ask Mr. Christian Valdez, valedictorian, to the podium to give us the invocation. Christian.
Hello. Let us pray. Gracious Father, we thank you for bringing us together today to celebrate the honorable recognition of our school's distinguished scholars. Bless and protect the students, their families, friends, teachers, and school staff who helped them come to this point. May their efforts and their success be present permanently in their lives and passed down to the next generation of scholars. And finally, Lord, bless us all here present and these your gifts, which we are about to receive, and those we have received from your goodness. We ask this in your name. Amen.
Thank you. Please be seated. I would like to ask now Ms. Veronica Galvan, Senior Class President, to give us a welcome address.
Good evening, and welcome to the 2019 Distinguished Level of Achievement with Collegiate Honors Scholars Banquet. I would like to thank each and every one of you for being here with us this evening. I would especially like to thank our principal, Mr. Marquez, and the assistant principal who have been here with us through this journey, guiding and leading us towards our success. We have all worked very hard, and this evening, the fruit of our labor is being recognized. Class of 2019, congratulations. Before we get started, I would like to express my sincere appreciation to our district administrators in attendance, board members, Southwest faculty and staff, and most importantly, our family members, all which have generously supported us throughout the last 4 years. Without your love and support, we would not be here today. We couldn't have done it without you. Thank you.
Thank you. Before we continue with our presentation, let me introduce PSGA administration and honorable community members who are key components in paving the road of opportunities enabling the success of our honored graduates. First of all, our superintendent of schools, Dr. Daniel King. PSGA school board members, Mr. Jesse Zambrano, president. Jorge George Palacios, vice president. Jorge Zambrano, treasurer. Ricardo Rick Pedraza, assistant secretary treasurer. Victor Perez, member. Jesus Jesse Vela, member. Carlos G. Villegas, member. And now on to our PSGA administration. Executive Officer for High Schools, Dr. Nora Cantu. Administrator for College Readiness, Linda Uribe. And Director for Counseling, Virginia Sines. PSGA Southwest Early College High School Administration, Principal Ranulfo Marquez. Dean of Instruction, myself, Jennifer Burden. Assistant Principal, Abraham Estrada. Assistant Principal, Robert Elizondo. Assistant Principal, Rocio Correa Garcia. Assistant Principal, Israel Nicanor. Head Counselor, Cynthia Saldana. And Counselors, Patricia Robles, Jessica Salinas, Ana Chavez, Fabiola Garcia, Ruby Valdez, Migrant Counselor, Hilda Araiza, and our Financial Aid Officer, Maria Guillen. At this time, I would like to invite our principal, Mr. Marquez, to share some words.
Good evening, parents, friends, and family, honored guests, and especially scholars of distinguished level of achievement with collegiate honors. I am privileged to be here tonight to welcome you and to congratulate you on behalf of the Southwest Early College High School Administration, our faculty, and our staff, and on behalf of the entire Javelina family. The students who are being recognized this evening have earned this honor by meeting a very high standard set by PSJA, which sets them apart from not only non-DLA graduates in this district, but from any graduates in this region, and I would venture to guess even in the entire state. Besides going above and beyond the required numbers of credits for high school graduation and earning an endorsement, every student in our DLACH class has either earned an associate's degree from South Texas College or is core complete in their post-secondary studies. That equals to about 2 years of college work completed while still in high school. Each of them has completed a senior capstone project, and the quality of these projects has been truly amazing. I encourage you to see some examples of them for yourself this Saturday at the Capstone Expo, which is being held at PSJA Early College High School in the morning at 8:30 a.m. They just did a tremendous, tremendous job with these capstone projects. And finally, each of them has completed a community service project, attended a college access program or tour, or enrolled in an internship related to their chosen degree plan or career. These accomplishments are truly amazing, and I don't know of any other graduates in our area that are achieving these feats in such a high number. I commend you on the choice that you made in choosing to graduate DLACH and on your commitment to see it all the way through. You are ready for the next level. You are more than ready. And when you do encounter difficulties in college or university, because that is a reality of life, There are always obstacles, always highs and lows. When you do encounter obstacles, you will be better prepared than your peers at that level to overcome them. You know how to prioritize and budget your time. You know how to self-advocate, and you know how to be resourceful and to ask for help when you need it. You know how to be successful at what you set your heart and mind to do. Students, I say this every year, and it's a problem that we as educators and school administrators love to face. I know Dr. King loves to have this problem. We all do. And that is that your legacy is that every year, each graduating class sets an even higher bar for the next generation of graduates. Your example leads the way for others, and whether you realize it or not, you serve as ambassadors for everything that Southwest Early College High School represents. Students and parents in our community, your younger brothers and sisters, your nephews, your nieces, your neighbors, they all look to you, they look at your success, and it makes them see Southwest Early College High School as the best place to go for a quality, well-rounded education with opportunities like no other. That is thanks to you. Some words of advice and encouragement: continue to be respectful, have integrity, be committed, and work hard. Does that sound familiar? Those are core values. You hear them every morning. They will guide you towards continued success. And remember to always use your gifts and talents to help others and to shape your community and the world. Go out there, continue your education, see it all the way through, and then consider coming back to PSJA to pay it forward to the next generation, hopefully at Southwest Early College High School. And finally, students, I'd like to congratulate you once again for your achievements. I'd also like to thank our district leadership, Superintendent Dr. King, and our school board for their vision, guidance, and support. And lastly, and most importantly, I'd like to thank our parents for their continued support in the education of their children. Thank you for bringing your children to school every day, for bringing them to tutoring when you needed to, for bringing them to practice, whether it was football or band or theater, to all those performances, and for helping them with their homework from the day that they were little kids all the way until now, for being so involved in their education. Time sure flies. It seems like just yesterday that they were in kindergarten, and now graduation is just a few days away. This is a great accomplishment that we are celebrating tonight, and we are so proud of your children, our students. Thank you, and congratulations, students. Javelinas for life. Jays up.
Thank you, Mr. Marquez. Our graduate success have been made possible by the efforts of many in this room, but it all began with the vision of our leader, Dr. King, who has taken PSJA to new heights and has supported PSJA Southwest Early College High School to build a legacy of readiness. Without further ado, Dr. Daniel King.
Good evening, students. Congratulations on a job well done. Your time spent in high school, the investment you've put into that effort has really paid off. You know, for such a young high school, I believe this is the fifth graduating class. Is that correct? The fifth graduating class?
Six.
My goodness, time flies. I'm getting older than I thought. But for being such a young high school, you have really put yourself on the map. For everything from state champions in theater arts, in track, and just very competitive in so many different areas, and also just the way that you carry yourselves there at your campus with a lot of class, and a lot of the different activities that you engage in, a lot of the community service that you do. So I want to thank you for that. And then in listening to Mr. Marquez talk about your accomplishments, and I guess I just have to say it right here too, Mr. Marquez, correct me if I'm wrong, but not only this group here, but I think it's due to these students because of the leadership of this group, But I've kind of challenged our principals that as we go over the next few years, that not only the top students do a capstone, but that all the seniors do a capstone. And I understand that over 90% of the senior class did a capstone. Is that correct? Almost 100%. So that's kind of throwing down the gauntlet to our other high schools. So that kind of shows that, you know, Southwest may be the new kid on the block, but you're kind of challenging the other high schools to step up, that you're not going to be taken for granted, or you're not going to be bringing up the rear. You're charging up to the front. So I want to thank you, because you're the leaders of this class, and you're the ones that set the example and have set the example. Your student group, your student leadership group that goes out and works with the other students and speaks to them and counsels them. But students, I want to congratulate you on a job well done, because as Mr. Marquez said, you didn't just do the minimum it took to get a high school diploma. You took on every challenge that was laid before you and more. You took on the extra coursework, the extra graduation requirements. You know, our Board of Trustees has very high expectations. And the graduation plan that they've approved and put forth goes way beyond anything that the state of Texas requires. And as Mr. Marquez says, is beyond what others do in terms of graduation, in terms of what it means to graduate with honors from PSJ. And so all those extra things that you asked to do, you've taken those on and more. Many of you are dual language graduates as well, which is, again, is very unique to PSJ to have so many dual language graduates. But I want to thank you for all of that and encourage you that as you go on to the college and university, whatever else you're going to do next, that you keep on with that same attitude. Take on the challenges, be the leaders, be the problem solvers, be the ones who help those around you, and you'll do well in life, and you'll enjoy life. Students or parents, I want to thank you for everything that you've done to help your sons and daughters get to this point, for working in partnership with us to help prepare them for the next step in life. We really appreciate the partnership that we have with you. Padres de familia, muchas gracias por todo que han hecho por sus hijos para ayudarles en llegar en este punto, que están listos ya para tomar el siguiente paso en su vida, por trabajar mano en mano con nosotros en enseñándoles. Ustedes son los primeros maestros, nosotros los segundos. Ustedes son sus primeros padres también, nosotros segundos. Entonces, la familia siempre es primero. La familia es número uno. De ahí, la comunidad, especialmente el sistema escolar. So, trabajando juntos, hemos llegado a este punto. Parents, I want to let you know that your children, these young people, they'll always be your children. You'll always be their parents, no matter how old they are. And you'll always be there to give them advice, to help offer a shoulder to them when they have problems, when they have concerns. And they will be turning to you for help. Padres, familia, sus hijos siempre les van a necesitar. Siempre, como padres, siempre somos padres. No importa la edad que tengan ellos. Nos van a necesitar consejos, van a necesitar ayuda a veces, si van al colegio o si no, a veces quieren un poquito de dinero, ¿verdad? Para ayudar. Ah, ya les han pedido. Ok. Quiero que ustedes entiendan que nosotros también, como sistema escolar, somos familia. Y nosotros, para nosotros también, esos alumnos siempre van a ser de nosotros, siempre van a pertenecer a PSJ. Y aunque van a graduar, ¿verdad? Primeramente muchos de STC esta semana y la otra semana de PSJ, aunque van a graduar, aquí estamos todavía para dar consejos, para dar ayuda. Hasta que PSJ tiene unas personas que están programados especialmente para ayudar a nuestros graduantes, mientras que siguen estudiando en el colegio, en la universidad, para ayudarles con cualquier problema. No hay ningún otro sistema escolar que tiene este tipo de posición, pero quiero hacer introducciones a unas personas que es muy importante que los conocen. Primeramente, les quiero introducir al señor Alonso García. Where is Mr. García? El señor Alonso García. Él es empleado de PSJ, es consejero empleado de PSJ. Tiene su oficina en Edimburgo, en la Universidad de Edimburgo. El trabajo de él es ayudarles a estudiantes, todos que van a seguir en el UTIGB. Él tiene oficina ahí, tiene oficina aquí también en nuestro distrito. Su trabajo es ayudarles si tienen cualquier problema con su horario, con matriculación, con buscando la manera de asistir, de finanzas, de cualquier cosa. Si tienen problemas, él está ahí. En su mesa, ahí, hay una tarjeta que parece un bookmark, una tarjeta así. Si se levanten, ahí van a ver, en un lado van a ver el nombre Alonso García. Ahí está su información de contacto. Ahí está su número telefónico, ¿verdad? Ahí está su dirección electrónica y ahí pueden ponerse en contacto con él o aquí después de este ceremonio también. Pueden buscarlo a él este verano, esta semana, el año que entra, el año que sigue de ahí. Todo el tiempo que están estudiando pueden buscar a él para buscar ayuda, consejos, cualquier cosa. Next, I want to introduce to you, les quiero introducir a Cristina Carrillo. Ella tiene su oficina at South Texas College, ahí en McAllen, y también tiene oficina aquí en nuestro distrito, es empleado también de nosotros. El propósito de ella, el trabajo de ella, es ayudar a todos que van a seguir estudiando en STC, en South Texas College, de vuelta con matriculación, con ayuda financiera, buscando cómo aplicar para becas, para ayuda del gobierno, para cualquier problema que tengan, ahí está ella. Su nombre también está en esta tarjeta, en la información, cómo ponerse en contacto con ella. También, thank you. Tenemos otro señor, no lo puedo introducir en esta noche porque me dice que su familia está engrandeciendo, ¿verdad? So, la familia va a tener otro niño y niña, so él no pudo estar aquí en esta noche. Felicidades por ellos. Pero el señor Carlos García, su nombre está aquí. Él está encargado de todo este programa y también él está encargado de todos los estudiantes que van a salir del Valle, para ayudarles con cualquier situación, cualquier problema, cualquier pregunta que tienen sobre sus estudios ahí. So, entonces, les pido que esta tarjeta, que no se lo pierdan, que eso les puede ayudar mucho. O si lo pierden, nomás ponerse en contacto con Mr. Marquez o con sus consejeros aquí y ellos ayuden en establecer el contacto para que les puedan seguir ayudando. Padres, felicidades. Esta es una celebración muy importante. Estamos muy orgullosos con ustedes de todo el éxito que han tenido sus hijos y vamos a compartir en este ceremonio y celebrar juntos. Gracias. Thank you very much, parents.
I would now like to invite our board president, Jesus Jesse Zambrano, to the podium to give us a few words.
Good evening. Buenas noches. Primeramente, le quiero dar las felicitaciones a todos los padres de familia que están aquí. Hoy es un día muy especial porque estamos honorando a sus hijos por el nivel académico que han cumplido todos los 4 años que estuvieron en high school. Es algo muy, muy especial para nosotros poder ayudar con la educación de sus hijos. Como decía Dr. King, la educación empieza en casa. La educación empieza con nuestros padres, con nuestros familiares, con todas esas personas que nos han ayudado a poder seguir adelante. Y sí sabemos que un certificado, un diploma, una carrera nos puede llevar mucho más adelante, pero también tenemos en mente que sin la ayuda de nuestros familiares y nuestros padres no podemos llegar a donde nosotros queremos. Students, I want to congratulate you for working hard these last 4 years. Obviously, your hard work has shown by being selected to be here tonight. And while your high school chapter is coming to a closure, really the rest of your life is just beginning. And so I'm just going to ask you to continue working hard and continue to always try to reach for the highest levels of achievement that you can. Never give up, always work hard. There's going to be some bumps in the road as you continue. Those will always be there, but it's your hard work and determination that are gonna get you through those situations and that are gonna continue to move you forward. Education plays a significant role in our community. And for some of you that are gonna be first-time college graduates, maybe some of you first-time high school graduates, this is the way that we continue to improve our society. This is the way that you continue to provide more opportunities for your family. And this is the way that we as a community continue to grow and continue to prosper. And so with that, once again, I want to congratulate all of you. I want to wish you well. PSJA will always be here for you. Javelina Nation will always be here for you. Please come back, visit your teachers. And your administrators here, because we need more people like you to continue to promote all the educational opportunities that we promote in PSJA. So once again, may God bless all of you. Que Dios los bendiga a todos.
Thank you for your kind words. I'd like to introduce our keynote speaker, Mr. Luis Eduardo Guerrero. Luis Guerrero was born in Reynosa, Mexico, and moved to FAR at the age of 5, where he attended PSJA ISD District until his graduation from PSJA Southwest in 2014, where he graduated top of his class. He obtained his bachelor's degree of sciences in petroleum geology from Texas A&M University in May of 2017. During his time at Texas A&M, Luis was a member of the Corps of Cadets, participated with the Smithsonian Latino Center Young Ambassador Program, and was an undergraduate researcher assistant at the International Ocean Discovery Program. He is currently a rising third-year law student at St. Mary's University School of Law in San Antonio. This past summer, Luis interned with Congressman Vicente Gonzalez in Washington, D.C. He currently works at a personal injury law firm, Chris Mayo Law Firm in San Antonio, Texas, as well as being involved with a startup vocational school in McAllen, Intertech. Luis one day plans to come back to the Rio Grande Valley, open his own law firm, and be an involved member of the community. Luis.
First and foremost, I want to thank the PSJA administration, the school board members, the Southwest administration, my counselor, Ms. Robles, but most importantly, the class of 2019 for this wonderful opportunity to be here today. I know I remember back in 2014 being in your shoes, super excited about what was coming next. I congratulate you all on your achievements, for you have gone the extra mile to be here today. También quiero agradecer y felicitar a los padres de los estudiantes porque la educación comienza en la casa. Cada uno de ellos hace un esfuerzo extraordinario para que ustedes salgan adelante y triunfen. Cuando todos terminemos de celebrar estos éxitos y ustedes continúen en su carrera o su trabajo, ellos seguirán estando allí, apoyándolos y aconsejándolos en cada paso del camino. You know, when I was first invited to this, I truly thought to myself, what can a 23-year-old really tell you about life? I'm still going through the uphill battle, still finding the individual I hope to be in the future. But what I see from my class of 2014 classmates is that we have firefighters, teachers, engineers, small business owners, to name a few. And I guarantee that our alumni system is growing and establishing itself in every aspect of the community to better the community. We, the class of 2014, are the oldest graduating class this school has, and we are young and hungry for success. I think we are setting the bar extremely high for future generations. But we must remember that we, as a community, as South Far, we are climbing a mountain together in which no one knows where it peaks. But as we climb, we must remember to throw the rope down to younger generations. It is my responsibility, it is my classmates' responsibility to leave our community in a better place than it was for your generation. But it is your responsibility to leave this community in a better place for the following classes. We must always be proud of where we come from and remember to go back to our roots, for our tree of success can only grow as tall and wide as our roots allow us to. I was born in Reynosa and came to the U.S. at the age of 5, where I attended PSJA schools from kinder to my senior year. And I am a proud product of PSJA. I may be biased. Actually, I'm extremely biased, but I think that this school district is the best district in the nation. The teachers and the faculty and the community always go above and beyond to make things happen. We are a reflection of their hard work and effort. I once asked one of my roommates in college what his parents thought about him coming to A&M. He told me his parents were happy because they paid less at A&M than they did at his high school. Keep in mind, cost of attendance at A&M is somewhere around $25,000 a year. Yet this did not belittle me. It allowed me to know that I could compete with any individual that stood in front of me, no matter the standard of life they had. Thanks to the opportunities and vision that PSJA and my parents instilled in me from a young age. I can guarantee you that when you walk out those doors at Southwest for the last time, you will be ready and able to do beautiful things in this world. Now, college is hard, don't get me wrong. It will test you, it will push you, and it will take every single ounce of energy to make it through. But do not let that discourage you from your goals. Continue making small, short-term goals, and before you know it, you will be well on your path towards your long-term goals. Stay focused, stay humble, and stay true to yourself, for college and life will test your values. It's not always gonna be black and white, right or wrong. Most decisions will fall in a gray area, and it is up to you to determine what is best for yourself. But always remember to keep people at the center of your world, for your life means something to someone other than you. Measure your amount of success, not in the amount of likes that you receive, but in the amount of lives that you impact. Trabajemos duro para asegurar que nuestras acciones y éxitos hablen por nosotros antes que nuestra colonia, nuestro color de piel o nuestro estado migratorio. Nos confrontaremos con mentalidades distintas que no creerán que nos merezcamos esas metas. La adversidad puede hacer que hasta uno dude, pero es en estos momentos que nos damos cuenta que el camino no es solitario, pero es una comunidad la que te guía en tu camino. Por eso mismo tenemos la responsabilidad de entender nuestras raíces, agradecer los sacrificios de nuestros padres y ver que seguimos en sus hombros. With all this division in our country today, attending one of the most conservative schools in the country allowed me to view that there was always a middle ground, no matter your beliefs, that the first step in reaching an agreement was to reach familiar ground for both parties. And this grounded me deeper in what I stand for. Yet we must continue to remain calm, understanding, and hear the other side of the argument. For we all grow from different viewpoints, which allow us to solidify our arguments. At the end of the day, we are all human, and we all seek love. So love and respect them for their differences. Now, this is not a sign of weakness. As a Latino immigrant, I know exactly what I stand for. And so for those who are close-minded and bigots, they have never seen the amount of potential and talent that I am honored to be in front of today. They have no idea that while they have been spitting out negative rhetoric about Latinos and other minorities, that we have been preparing ourselves and that our people have awoken. With that being said, as you start your journey into college, join the workforce, or join the armed forces, do remember that we are not only the generation of the future, but also the generation of today. For this school has prepared us to succeed in any endeavor we choose to take. Go out there and make us proud. Thank you so much, and congratulations to the class of 2019.
What an absolutely outstanding speech.
And now announcing our distinguished scholars. Cassandra Alexa Abad, daughter of Sonia Espinosa. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. She will attend the University of Texas at San Antonio and will major in kinesiology. Brian Daniel Acosta, son of Elia and Jesus Acosta. His notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. He will attend UTRGV and will major in biology. Glenn Melanie Aguirre, daughter of Blanca and Luis Aguirre. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. She will attend UTRGV and will major in industrial engineering. Diana Elizabeth Alanis, daughter of Veronica and Edwin Alanis. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. She will attend UTRGV and will major in sociology. Isaias Alfaro, son of Magdalena and Isaias Alfaro Jr. His notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. He will attend UTRGV and will major in computer science. Sergio Ivan Archer Jr., son of Alexandra and Sergio Ivan Archer. His notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. He will attend UTRGV and will major in business administration. Genesis Briones, daughter of Maria and Jorge Briones Sr. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. She will attend UTRGV and will major in elementary education. Ingrid Armida Cano, daughter of Araceli and Noe Ivan Cano. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. She will attend UTRGV and will major in English. Lisbeth Cepeda, daughter of Maria Cepeda. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. She will attend UTRGV and will major in English and journalism. Naya Ludvika Coronada Zarate, daughter of Nidia and Benigno Coronado. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. She will attend UTRGV and will major in early childhood education. Jesus Adrian Cuella Sanchez, son of Maria and Alejandro Cuella. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. He will attend UTRGV and will major in communication. Jacqueline Escoto, daughter of Cecilia Garza and Oscar Escoto. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in criminal justice with a total of 70 hours of college credit. She will attend UTRGV and will major in criminal justice. Jose Antonio Estrada, son of Josie Leal. His notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. He will attend UTRGV and will major in history. Jacqueline Galicia, daughter of Elvia and Jaime Galicia. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. She will attend UTRGV and will major in business administration. Tomas Jose Garcia, son of Maria Arredondo and Tomas Garcia. His notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. He will attend UTRGV and will major in occupational therapy. Eliasad Garza Jr., son of Ludivina and Eliasad Garza. His notable achievement is earning a total of 42 hours of college credit. He will attend UTRGV and will major in psychology. Cristina Gonzalez Valdez, daughter of San Juana and Humberto Gonzalez. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. She will attend UTRGV and will major in kinesiology. Ethan Hector Carlos Grino, son of Laura Garcia and Shane Grino. His notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. He will attend New York University and will major in film production. Cassandra Guerrero, daughter of Sonia and Abdiel Guerrero. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. She will attend South Texas College and will major in graphics arts. Alain Gutierrez, son of Claudia Gutierrez. His notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. He will attend the University of Texas at San Antonio and will major in accounting. Jacqueline Jimenez, daughter of Maria Rodriguez. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. She will attend Texas A&M at Kingsville and will major in biomedical sciences. Francisco Lopez, son of Maria Teresa Casas. His notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. He will attend Stephen F. Austin State University and will major in education. Kate Luna, daughter of Ana Rios and Roberto Luna. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. She will attend UTRGV and will major in criminal justice. Pamela Lizette Maldonado Ocañas, daughter of Lydia and Gabriel Maldonado. Her notable achievement is earning a total of 45 hours of college credit. She will attend UTRGV and will major in pre-med. Kevin Marroquin, son of Elizabeth and Jesus Marroquin. His notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in criminal justice with a total of 60 hours of college credit. He will attend UTRGV and will major in criminal justice. Andre Ricardo Martinez Cortez, son of Claudine Cortez and Ricardo Martinez. His notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. He will attend Texas A&M University at Kingsville and will major in music education. Angel Isai Martinez, son of Marisol and Jose Martinez. His notable achievement is earning a total of 45 hours of college credit. He will attend UTRGV and will major in English. Aide Lizette Martinez, daughter of Yolanda Ramirez and Gerardo Martinez. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. She will attend South Texas College and will major in radiology. Gilberto Andre Martinez, son of Elisa Guajardo and Gilberto Martinez. His notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. He will attend UTRGV and will major in biology. Jeffrey Joel Martinez, son of Nancy Noceda. His notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. He will attend UTRGV and will major in mathematics. Maciel Martinez, daughter of Sara Martinez and Mark Sanchez. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. She will attend Texas A&M College Station and will major in biomedical science. Valeria Martinez, daughter of Celene Garza and Rodrigo Mendoza. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. She will attend UTRGV and will major in biochemistry. Sonia Edith Mata, daughter of Sue Hernandez and Alberto Mata. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. She will attend UTRGV and will major in communication studies. Itzel Yaciri Melendez, daughter of Rosa Maria Sauceda and Juan Melendez. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 64 hours of college credit. She will attend UTRGV and will major in psychology. Lisbeth Melendez, daughter of Dora and Raul De Leon. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. She will attend South Texas College and will major in liberal arts. Melanie Aide Montesinos, daughter of Maria Sanchez and Martin Montesinos. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. She will attend the University of Texas at San Antonio and will major in psychology. Carolina Montoya, daughter of Nancy and Melicio Montoya. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. She will attend Texas State University and will major in computer science. Nicholas Andrew Nicanor, son of Valentina and Israel Nicanor. His notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 61 hours of college credit. He will attend UTRGV and will major in biology. Daniela Nino, daughter of Sofia and Manuel Nino. Her notable achievement is earning a total of 52 hours of college credit. She will attend UTRGV and will major in liberal arts. Maria Juanita Ortiz, daughter of Amy Morales and Armando de los Santos Sr. Her notable achievement is earning a total of 45 hours of college credit. She will attend Texas A&M University at Corpus Christi and will major in English. Rolando Perez Jr., son of Ana and Rolando Perez. His notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. He will attend UTRGV and will major in computer science. Ashley Pozos, daughter of Olivia and Miguel Pozos. Her notable achievement is earning a total of 45 hours of college credit. She will attend UTRGV and will major in physical therapy. Ivan J. Puente, son of Jessica and Israel Puente. His notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. He will attend UTRGV and will major in criminal justice. Ruby Marie Quintero, daughter of San Juanita Chapa and Baltazar Quintero. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. She will attend Texas State University and will major in fashion merchandising. Destiny Lynn Ramirez, daughter of Jessica and Rigoberto Ramirez. Her notable achievement is earning a total of 45 hours of college credit. She will attend South Texas College and will major in culinary arts. Frankie Yamil Ramos, son of Martha and Frankie Ramos. His notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies as well as science with a total of 69 hours of college credit. He will attend UTRGV and will major in electrical engineering. Jesuel Daniel Ramos, son of Herminia and Juan Daniel Ramos. His notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. He will attend Stephen F. Austin University and will major in agriculture business. Victoria Monique Raso, daughter of Maribel and Alejandro Raso. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. She will attend Our Lady of the Lake University and will major in multimedia journalism. Noel Rizendez, son of Lizeth Rodriguez. His notable achievement is earning a total of 48 hours of college credit. He will attend UTRGV and will major in engineering. Elva Mariana Reyna, daughter of Cristina Martinez and Alejandro Reyna. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in business administration with a total of 60 hours of college credit. She will attend UTRGV and will major in international business. Daniela Rios, daughter of Evelyn and Rolando Rios. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. She will attend UTRGV and will major in education. Alejandro Rodriguez, son of Sandra and Jorge Luis Rodriguez. His notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. He will attend UTRGV and will major in engineering. Victoria Lee Rodriguez, daughter of Veronica Rodriguez. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in criminal justice with a total of 60 hours of college credit. She will attend UTRGV and will major in criminal justice. Jorge Rojas, son of Maria Guadalupe and Baltazar Rojas. His notable achievement is earning a total of 48 hours of college credit. He will attend UTRGV and will major in criminal justice. Antonio Alexis Roman, son of Marisa Villarreal. His notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 77 hours of college credit. He will attend UTRGV and will major in electrical engineering. Sydney Salinas, daughter of Mila Edith and Juan Ismael Salinas. Her notable achievement is earning a total of 46 hours of college credit. She will attend UTRGV and will major in business management. Marisa Lynn Sanchez, daughter of Delfina and Mario Sanchez. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. She will attend UTRGV and will major in liberal arts. Daniela Sepúlveda, daughter of Nora and Sergio Sepúlveda. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. She will attend Texas State University and will major in studio art. Wendy Nayeli Tijerina, daughter of Gabriela and Cesar Tijerina. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. She will attend South Texas College and will major in medical health science services management. Priscilla Giselle Vela, daughter of Denise Lopez and Eric Vela. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. She will attend South Texas College and will major in nursing. Jose Luis Ventura, son of Sarai Villanueva and Jose Ventura. His notable achievements are earning an associate's degree in welding technology and an SCC certificate in structural welding with a total of 62 hours of college credit. He will attend UTRGV and will major in mechanical engineering. And now the top 10 present, top 10%. Number 42, Fatima Alexandria Rukova, daughter of Xochitl Rukoba and Noe Tirado. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 61 hours of college credit. She will attend Texas A&M at Corpus Christi and will major in criminal justice. Yes. Number 41, Jacqueline Itzel Lopez, daughter of Veronica Gonzalez. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in biology with a total of 66 hours of college credit. She will attend UTRGV and will major in biology. Number 40, Kimberly Perez, daughter of Lori Pessina. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in biology with a total of 75 hours of college credit. She will attend South Texas College and will major in nursing. Number 39, Brandon Marquez, son of Fabiola Marquez and Mario Santana. His notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in criminal justice with a total of 60 hours of college credit. He will attend UTRGV and will major in criminal justice. Number 38, Jocelyn Cassandra Ramirez, daughter of Esther and Juan Ramirez. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 64 hours of college credit. She will attend UTRGV and will major in biochemistry. Number 37, Carla Rochelle Kessler, daughter of Esther Mendez and Carlos Kessler. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. She will attend Texas A&M College Station and will major in biology. Number 36, Mariana Lizeth Matamoros, daughter of Elizabeth Rivera and Jorge Matamoros. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. She will attend UTRGV and will major in mathematics. Number 35, Viviana De Leon, daughter of Maria Guadalupe De Leon. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. She will attend UTRGV and will major in liberal arts. Number 34, Francisco Rodriguez, son of Claudia and Mario Rodriguez. His notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. He will attend UTRGV and will major in mathematics. Number 33, Veronica Raquel Galvan, daughter of Erica and Oscar Galvan. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 63 hours of college credit. She will attend UTRGV and will major in biomedical science. Number 32, Sebastian Nicholas Rivera, son of Veronica Rivera. His notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in mathematics with a total of 66 hours of college credit. He will attend Embry-Riddle Aeronautical University and will major in aerospace engineering. Number 31, Yasmin Vasquez, daughter of Yanet and Genaro Vasquez. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. She will attend UTRGV and will major in international business. Number 30, Armando Torres, son of Griselda Hernandez and Armando Torres. His notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in mathematics with a total of 60 hours of college credit. He will attend the University of Texas at San Antonio and will major in architecture. Number 29, Brittany Ashley Troches, daughter of Maile Martinez and Juan Troches. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 62 hours of college credit. She will attend Texas A&M International University and will major in nursing. Number 28, Francisco Rodriguez Jr., son of Lilia E. Rivera. His notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. He will attend UTRGV and will major in computer science. Number 27, Alejandro Tijerina, son of Claudia Ibarra and Hugo Tijerina. His notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 62 hours of college credit. He will attend UTRGV and will major in nutrition and health. Number 26, Moises Nevarez, son of Blanca Coronado and Jaime Nevarez. His notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 62 hours of college credit. You will attend UTRGV and will major in computer engineering. Number 25, Mark David Sandoval, son of Diana and Mark Sandoval. His notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. He will attend UTRGV and will major in psychology. Number 24, Aaron Fenton Kintai, son of Catherine and Gary Kintai. His notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. He will attend the University of Texas at Austin and will major in anthropology. Number 23, Esmeralda Mesa, daughter of Corina and Alberto Mesa. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. She will attend Stephen F. Austin State University and will major in dance. Maybelle Lisbeth Mendoza, number 22, daughter of Maria del Rosario and Patricio Mendoza. Her notable achievement is earning a total of 40 hours in college credit. Number 21, Carla Lisbeth Reyes, daughter of Myra Clemente and Carlos Reyes. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. She will attend Texas State University and will major in music. Number 20, Celeste Aurora Robles, daughter of Patricia and Javier Robles. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 62 hours of college credit. She will attend the University of Texas at Austin and will major in radio, television, film, and journalism. Number 19, Carolina Morales, daughter of Maribel and Jose Morales. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. She will attend UTRGV and will major in industrial engineering. Number 18, Jorge Eduardo Villagomez, son of Veronica Regino and Oscar Villagomez. His notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in criminal justice with a total of 60 hours of college credit. He will attend UTRGV and will major in criminal justice. Number 17, Daisy Irene Chavez, daughter of Belinda Isaac and Jose Chavez. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. She will attend Texas A&M and will major in biomedical science. Number 16, Carlos Pelayo, son of Xiomara Morales. His notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in criminal justice with a total of 60 hours of college credit. He will attend UTRGV and will major in criminal justice. Number 15, Marianne Aide Mejia Pedraza, daughter of Yadira Pedraza and Jose Mejia. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. She will attend UTRGV and will major in biomedical sciences. Number 14, Shelby Itzel Gonzalez, daughter of Maria de Jesus and Carlos Gonzalez. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 65 hours of college credit. She will attend UTRGV and will major in psychology. Number 13, Caitlin Hope Hilton, daughter of Angelina and Michael Hilton. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. She will attend University of Houston and will major in pre-med. Number 12, Linda Grimaldo, daughter of Claudia and Enrique Grimaldo. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 66 hours of college credit. She will attend UTRGV and will major in computer science. Number 11, Daniela Medina, daughter of Olga Hernandez. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. She will attend Texas A&M Corpus Christi and will major in English. Number 10, Rebecca Caro, daughter of Norma Rodriguez and Robert Caro. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. She will attend the University of Texas at Austin and will major in physiology and applied movement science. Number 9, Emily Jacqueline Garcia, daughter of Araceli and Francisco Garcia. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 61 hours of college credit. She will attend UTRGV and will major in business administration. Number 8, Aaron Eduardo Salinas, son of Idolinda and Gerardo Salinas. His notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in precision manufacturing technology with a total of 60 hours of college credit. He will attend UTRGV and will major in manufacturing engineering. Number 7, Galilea Betsabe Puente, daughter of Ruth and David Rodriguez. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 60 hours of college credit. She will join the Navy as a hospital corpsman. Number 6, Jorge Sanchez Jr., son of Isabel and Jorge Sanchez. His notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in criminal justice with a total of 69 hours of college credit. He will attend UTRGV and will major in criminal justice. Number 5, Nayeli Nicole Salazar, daughter of Karina and Carlos Salazar. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in business administration with a total of 68 hours of college credit. She will attend the University of Texas at Austin and will major in corporate communications. Number 4, Edgar Perez, son of Marta Gonzalez. His notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 68 hours of college credit. He will attend UTRGV and will major in biology. Number three, Dioselina de la Cruz, daughter of Irma and Juan de la Cruz. Her notable achievement is earning an associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 70 hours of college credit. She will attend the University of Texas at Austin and will major in international business. Our salutatorian, Melody Castillo, daughter of Leticia and Agapito Castillo. Her notable achievement are earning an associate's degree in business administration and an SCC certificate in small business management with a total of 110 hours of college credit. She will attend UTRGV and will major in business administration. And our valedictorian, Christian Ormar Valdez, son of Yolanda Martinez. His notable achievement is earning associate's degree in interdisciplinary studies with a total of 68 hours of college credit. He will attend UTRGV and will major in mathematics. At this time, I ask that all parents and everyone else in the audience please stand up and give these wonderful students a round of applause.
On behalf of the Southwest Administration, faculty, and staff, we would like to thank our counselors for all their support and dedication to our scholars. Let's give them a round of applause, the counselors. They are an integral part of the continued success of all our students. I would like for all of our parents and our scholars to stand at this time. Parents, scholars, please stand. Parents, padres de familia, por favor. To our parents of these distinguished scholars, thank you for supporting, motivating, and guiding these scholars to rise above all obstacles and challenges. Their success is our reward. Please be seated. Distinguished 2019 scholars, we thank you for your hard work and commitment that has led to all your outstanding accomplishments. We wish you success in all your endeavors. I'd like to thank Ms. Melody Castillo to the podium to lead us in a final benediction. Melody Castillo?
Let us bow our heads. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for bringing our parents, friends, teachers, counselors, and administrators together to celebrate and helping us achieve our goals that you have bestowed upon us. Through your gracious mercy and protection, we commit ourselves to you. May our precious spirit lift, comfort, and bring us peace. Allow your gracious light shine upon us forevermore. Amen. Once again, thank you for joining us. Have a wonderful evening.